In this video, I will show you how to convert a normal, basically my Wi-Fi charger is burned. So today I have a charger, another charger, basically removed the power supply. So this is a 12 volt charger, and the Wi-Fi original charger is 9 volt charger. So basically both chargers 1000 milliamps, meaning both are charging same 1000 milliamps, meaning 1 amp, and both charger input 240 volt input, and both charger are the out input AC to output DC converter. So why we cannot use this charger instead we are my Wi-Fi charger? But problem is this charger is Wi-Fi charger is 9 volt, so this is 12 volt. That is I use this regulator LM7809 regulator, voltage regulator. So basically 3 pins, input 12 volt, ground, output 9 volt. And now begin to work. This is a Wi-Fi. This Wi-Fi charger is. Now begin the work. Working, we first know the priority. Priority is not find difficult because this state I use this power supply only voltmeter. So it is analog voltmeter, so just priority is not matter at all. So all we need to do just remove the wire of power supply. Now I need only voltmeter, not a power supply. So that's why I need not remove voltmeter to power supply fully, because later I can reconnect the wire and use back it. So now remove this wire here. Only use voltmeter, not a this power supply. So open this way and remove this wire. This wire and well, open this fully. So this charger can face output 9 volt, 12 volt, 9 volt one is burned. So I can replace with 12 volt with an add-on converter. So that's why I'm not test you a 9 volt one performance, because 9 volt one is fully burned. Now check priority of 12 volt one, because when priority between that is no, priority is wrong, the needle is moved left away, meaning if priority is fine, needle goes forward, and when priority is on, needle goes backward. So this way I can know what this priority is. So basically I can connect the one wire. So you can see needle goes backward. Now I replace the priority and now check again. So you can see it can up to similarly. I can drop this charger wire. So basically this wire. Okay, now. But now I'm telling you, I cannot drop like there. I can drop just center. If this thing is not work very well, I can back join in. 1, 2, 3, go. Cut it. And now near priority. This case, I can, you, if you have a multimeter, you can set a multimeter continuity to test it. Because you can use a probe. Multimeter one probe right there, and other probe touch in pin, and one is touch there, and which is big, you can know which one is. But this is my multimeter is fully dead, so I can not use. Basically you can see charger says this symbol, meaning outer shell is negative and inner shell is positive. So meaning this test is inner is positive and outer is negative. Now I can flip these wires. So there is it. This is priorities matter, otherwise anything is going on. Well, so I can flip it completely. And now turn on this lab bench power supply. My real lab bench power supply. So there is a power wire. Just plug in and this is power supply is turned on. Power supply one wire connecting to the. This is I then use my analog setup to do that, because my multimeter is fully dead. So this is the power supply negative connect. The voltmeter negative and voltmeter positive, and power supply positive. It will not matter. You can use join positive to positive, negative to lose them. But I connect negative to dead and positive lose. When touch this positive, you can see this multimeter can show reading. So now I connect one wire of the first leg positive to one, this one, these wires, and other side touch the ring. Well, not level. Well, I connect this one, so you can see the result. Meaning this wire connect is this shell. So inner shell is positive. So it can say the inner shell is positive and outer shell is negative. When inner shell is connected with this wire, meaning outer shell is connected this wire, meaning automatically meaning this inner wire is the inner shell. Now I can remove, so I know this wire is positive. And I also made accidentally mistake is that I can not mark on the charger which one is positive and which one is negative. So basically the charger I can test up like previously, but I cannot make the mark which the indication mark which know which one is positive. So there's negative and there is positive. Right now recheck it again because this thing, if you connect long quality it can kill your wire pack or anything with bond. So that's why we can carefully do so. I know this is a positive one wire. So I also ties together. So tie acts like a mark. So this is if you have marker or whitener, you can wipe this, and I like it, but I just tie together. So which says help me to figure out which one is. So there's a regulator. The regulator are 3 pins. If you switch towards the regulator, not a variable one. So this case I can connect this up in pin number 1 for input positive, which is there, and this is a negative, which will is a common for output and input. So which we I connect right there. And now I can take a third lead wire, this one. For this case, longer wire is the negative wire. Same this wire also connect the middle pin of the regulator. And this wire is remaining output 9 volt wire. Positive wire of lead is connecting the last point of the regulator is. So remaining last terminal. So this I then tie a little bit other software together. So that's why it is little bit this one is tricky, but it still works. So then now we can see wiring diagram. So they have positive to pin number regulator, input positive for charger is connected to the regulator input. And the charger negative is connected to the regulator ground pin, middle pin. And regulator middle pin is also output negative. And output positive is third pin of the regulator. If it is not matter, you can use any input charger above to 9 volt. So you can get output 9 volt. It is not, this regulator is not only available in 9 volt, 5 volt, 8 volt and 12 volt version. So you can use also phone charger is. You can use a 12 volt 2 amp charger to convert 5 volt output with. Charge your phone with 2. I know I can do a very bad way because my wire is not too close, so there are risks for short circuit. Now I can measure the output voltage. So I can bend it basically this pin is. So their problem I can get is that this was two close pins. So that's it. I can make a little bit short circuit this charger pins, so that's why it won't. So now I can, now ground is take a side one. Now you can see out it's 9 volt. And well input is, yes, I can remove one probe. Set back the 12 volt input side. And 12.5 and output is 9 volt. It is 14. Now let this last wire of this lead pin, this which pin is connecting to a charger. I mean this pin is connecting to a wire. Now goes this pin. Now remove a negative evidence, anything, and just connect positive. You can see it is properly. So outer shell is negative and inner shell is positive. 9 volts, okay. Now check right there. So this says okay. Outer shell is negative and inner is positive. Same right there. Let me check it. Now it's connect to Wi-Fi. So this is basically 9 volt Wi-Fi. So you can see it is working. All LEDs is working. So you can see this all LEDs is blinking. Maybe it is too light for because I just turn on my camera light. So you can see these are working. As you can see, it is working. Although there is not an internet connection because due to I can not connect an internet wire. So all we need to do just tape it and attach the location. This is a small with little experiment. You can involve your cell phone charge, any kind charger to your cell phone charger or your Wi-Fi charger with any range. Just easy, you can use LM78 models regulators, 7805, 7808 or 708 or 9. It is not matter but you can use your own choice because it is a 9 volt version, so I can use a 9 volt. If you have 12 volt one, you can use 24 volt charger to 12 volt and working, you can use 12 volt one. If you need a 5 volt, you can use 5 volt one, or if you need a 8 volt and 8 volt one, not a 7 volt. So it cannot come with 7 volt. That case you can use a variable LM31 7 regulator. You can use to output is connecting a voltage divider to fixed one. You can input 40 volt, output you can then get 1 to 40 volt with various levels according to your requirement. And this is a small little project, and this will then become